Hello and welcome to the Wolfire Alpha Map Editor tutorial. Today we will be showing you how to use the Map Editor's toolset and the function of each tool. We'll show you how to play with Rabbot and have him interact with the environment. And we'll also be showing you how to build your own structures. Alright, let's start by taking a look at our toolkit here. You can see from the rollover tooltips that we have the Load Object tool, the Translate tool, Scale, Rotate, Add Object, and Select. So first let's start with the translation tool. We're going to take our object here. Using left click, we can use the generic translation relative to the camera just to move this object around. And now using right click, we can use a translation space relative to the plane we select with right click. And you can see the grid system laying out where we're going to be moving the object. We can move it off into infinity there, bring it back. And if we hold shift, we can actually translate along the normal of the planes. So you can see that using right click and just one of the planes on the cube and then occasionally shift, we can actually translate the cube along all three axes to put it anywhere we want on the screen. So the next tool we're going to be talking about is the rotation tool. This is me right clicking on various planes of the cube, and right click is probably what you want to stick to most of the time because it preserves most of the original orientation of the cube. So if you're making a building, it's really helpful to keep everything aligned together. But you can also left click, like I'm doing now, and you get a freeform rotation. It's also a great way to preview objects. You can see the lighting and shading effects are really highlighted there as I move the object around. So if you're a talented artist like Aubrey, you probably will never need this function, but for the rest of us, Control-Z is your best friend. That's the undo button, and Control-Shift-Z is redo. The next tool is the scaling tool. You can see that with left click, you can scale the entire object to make it larger or smaller, but keep all the proportions the same. Then with right click, the behavior is very similar to the translation tool, because if I right click on a face, I can move the corner nearest to my right click along two axes. And then if I hold shift, I can distort and scale the object along the normal to the plane. Fans of Photoshop will like this next feature. Here I am with the translation tool and holding Alt. And what happens is not only do I translate an object, but this new object is a clone of the original object. And then again, if I hold Shift, it all becomes relative to the normal, to the selected plane, and I can make clones in all three dimensions. And as you might expect intuitively, you can select multiple objects at the same time, and then Alt-Drag with the translation tool and you'll copy multiple objects simultaneously. Beyond regular right-click, Alt-Shift cloning, I can also hold down Control to enable the Map Editor snap system, and this allows me to nestle cubes together perfectly adjacently to each other so that I can tile them to make floors and other objects. Alright, I'm going to show you another way to select multiple objects at the same time. If you hold right click and left click together, you can use the box select tool. Just drag the box around all the objects you want to select together. If you push delete, all the selected objects disappear. But now I'm going to select another set of objects and I'm going to press Control G. This groups them together and I can create multiple groups. And then once I have groups, I can even select them all and create one giant group out of the groups. So that's what I've done here. Now it's really easy to reselect the whole group and manipulate all the objects in the group together. And to degroup, I just press Control-Shift-G. Intuitively, a group of objects can be copied and pasted elsewhere by using Control-C and then Control-V. And of course, Control-V will place the cloned set of objects wherever your cursor was at the time that you press Control-V. Okay, let's put all the tricks we've learned together to make a quick test level for Rabbot and see if he can handle this. Just press 8 to
send in Rabbot.
Oh, there's no staircase. I can just push 9 to go back to editing mode. And I can push 8 again to go back to Rabbot. No beatboxing this time, I promise.
Alright, Rabbot, jump. Get there.
Very nice. Great success.
Look at Rabbot standing there all cocky. A little OD updating will take care of that.
Whoa!
Alright, so you've seen how to build a chaotic jungle gym made out of blocks, but maybe you actually want to try building a real-looking building asset for a change.
No, this isn't 10x speed. I'm just that good.
Hope you've enjoyed this map editor tour, and please feel free to check out the Wolfire blog for the latest Overgrowth development news, and happy modding!